It's going great. This is day three of a 1 week long strike, and you can hear we have the enthusiasm, we have the participation, especially early in the morning, because most housekeepers work the morning shift, and that's why they're here in the morning. But it's a 24-hour day strike, 7 days of this week.
Is that why your voice is a little hoarse?
A little bit, and I'm a little sunburned, but and I was thrown in jail yesterday.
Oh, really? What happened?
Well, you know, West Hollywood as a city has a reputation as being progressive, but it's just not the case. And the city officials act like they work for the Hyatt Hotel, and maybe they do. And every single thing has been a problem. This banner, having a table to hold our materials, having that steak bed, even having the porta potties. You know, it was over 100 degrees the first day that we struck. People need to hydrate themselves, and obviously, human dignity means that they have the right to use a bathroom. And the city was fighting us on all of those things, and they continue to do so.
So you applied for permits in advance, and they didn't
issue
them, or what?
No, we didn't, because our concern would be that they would notify the company. They're very close to the company. We wanted to catch them by surprise. But you shouldn't have to apply for a permit ahead of time. In this country, it's a right to strike. And, you know, these workers are making a huge sacrifice, losing their wages for a whole week. As it is, they live on the edge. But they're willing to make that sacrifice because it's been 2 years, almost 2 years, that we've been without a contract. And of all the hotel chains, Hyatt is by far the most abusive. The way they treat their housekeepers, housekeepers have injury rates that are higher than any other hotel chain, by far. What they did to the Hyatt 100 in Boston, fired 100 housekeepers and replaced them with agency workers. Just threw them out on the streets. What they did to the workers that were on strike in Chicago, one of the hottest days ever in Chicago history. And on that day, they turned on the heat lamps that on the sidewalk, which are used, you know, for the winter time to try to kill people. So that's the type of company we're dealing with.
Wow. So how long are you guys going to be out here, and what is it you're asking for? What would it take for them to get you off the sidewalk?
Well, we're striking for a week to send a strong message. We have negotiations, actually, on Thursday, and we hope that they're, you know, they'll see that we're only getting stronger. We're not going to give up. We're going to fight until we win, just like we always have.
Have they brought in scabs?
Oh, of course. Yep. Poor agency workers, they throw them in a van.
That's probably what you don't buy agency.
Probably don't tell them what they're doing and what they're getting themselves into, and in a van with darkened windows, and they bring them into the hotel. Wow.